I am Marion Buricatu, a French and American artist. I am also an art teacher at the Hopkinton Center for the Art and a docent at the Worcester Art Museum.
And hi, I'm Domiti, Marion's daughter.
So today we will be telling you the story of the longest battle in human history.
Oh wait, I wouldn't call it just a battle. This is an all-out war.
And there are two sides to in this story.
Red and blue, we hope you can tell. Today we will settle this once and for all.
Viewers, choose your side wisely. This is about to get real.
Okay, so I'm going to start.
No. I'll start. Okay, red is the first pigment. Let's be clear. Blue does not exist. From the oldest painting by man 33,000 years ago in the Lascaux Caves, to the Egyptians, to the Greek, to the end of the Roman Empire, blue, sorry, you do not exist.
You are lying, and I'll tell you why. The ancient Egyptians used a lot of blue, as you can see in this painting at the Met Museum of Art in NYC.
Yes, sure, for funeral rites? To ward off evils? Great!
You know what? People die all the time, and it's very important to represent that. Anyways, let's be serious for a second.
Yes! Red pigments were so common and gave the best result for painting and dyeing fabric. Basically, red was the first color ever.
Well, I guess that is pretty important. But blue also had its own pigments.
Oh yeah? Like what?
Well, in antiquity, blue was sometimes made from a plant called indigo, as you can see on this picture. Indigo was very expensive because it came all the way from Asia and Africa. What about you?
Well, for red, there was not just expensive pigment. In general, there were a lot of pigments. And there are three kinds of pigment sources. The first kind is the animal sources. Then the second one is the plant sources. And the third one is the mineral sources.
Okay, give me an example of an animal source.
Okay, so Tyrian purple came from a shellfish from the Mediterranean Sea, and it was used to make a beautiful, bright and deep red, and it was very, very, very expensive, and became a symbol of power, like this polychrome reconstruction of the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus.
Wow, sounds grand. Now tell me about the second source, plant sources.
Okay, so one of the most common red pigments came from the plant. Madder. And madder in French is garance, which is the name of my second daughter.
You are an artist at heart, naming your daughters after pigments. Anyways, let's talk about the third source, mineral sources.
Alright, so there were a lot of mineral pigments for red. Several were very beautiful but very toxic, like for example vermilion. Otherwise, there was red ochre, which was a natural clay, and hematite, which is an iron ore, also very common.
Okay, so you have a lot of pigments. But blue is everywhere in nature. The sky, the sea, those are some pretty big masses, and they're pretty obvious.
Well, blue, but you have one big problem.
And what is that?
Blue, you do not exist. For the Romans.
First of all, I heard that stage whisper. And second of all, what do you mean I don't exist?
Well, look at the Greek and the Romans. For them, blue, grey and green are the same. There is literally no vocab word for the color blue in Latin. And on top of that, historians in the 19th century even thought that they were blind to these colors because they were not mentioned.
Okay, so that part is true. But what about Germanic populations? They use woad, another plant, to dye their textiles in blue. And the word for blue comes from the Germanic word blau, B-L-A-U. So you see, we do exist.
Well, but you are just proving my point. I'm sorry about that, blue. Yes, their blue was a common color for Germanic population. But they were barbaric people for the Romans, and no one ever wants to be unfashionable. Even Romans followed trends.
You've clearly been on Instagram too much.
And I'm not even done yet. Yes, for the Romans, a woman with blue eyes was a sign of disrepute and dishonesty.
All of this coming from someone who's not even Italian and is 50% German. The irony.
Oops. So, I'll do the conclusion. Because you are a sore loser.
Yes, it was a low blow.
Alright, red wins this battle. 1 for me, 0 for blue. Let's do a quick recap why I won.
Yes, okay. Tell me the first reason why you won this battle.
Red is the first color because it's readily available.
Okay, and number two?
Blue does not exist because it's a barbaric color.
I object, but we want to talk about one very important concept before we end this video. In antiquity, the concept of color does not exist. People didn't like or not like a color. They liked that red shirt or this blue shirt. And it's really important not to project our cultural context of a color and everything it means to us onto how other people saw colors. Keep that in mind throughout these videos.
And finally, these videos were created based on the research of a French historian named Michel Pastoureau, who is a real pioneer in the field of the history of colors. All his books are available in English.
Yes, and it's also full of information, which is why it took us so long to make these videos.
Yes, and remember, I won this battle. Score for red, 1 for blue, 0.
You are now an art expert. We'll see you in the next video with some trivia questions.
Bye bye. A French and American artist. I am also an art teacher at the Hopkinton Center for the Arts and a docent at the Worcester Art Museum. In this video, we will ask you some fun trivia questions about the battle between red and blue during the antiquity.
Okay, so I'm going to be asking the questions and Mom is going to be giving the answers.
Yay.
Question number one, why was red the first color? 1, because it was the prettiest color. 2, because it was readily available. Or 3, because blood is red.
Well, all of them are right.
Yes.
But the right answer is because it was readily available.
Good job, Mom. Question number 2. For what did ancient Egyptians use the color blue? As a jewel, for makeup, or for funeral rites?
For funeral rites, mostly.
Yep, and they also used coal, which is black, for makeup.
Yes.
Anyways, question number 3. What are the sources of natural pigments? 1, animals. 2, plants. And 3, minerals.
Well, all right answers.
Yes.
Bravo!
You gave an example for red pigments from each of them.
Yes, yes.
Okay, question 4. Where did Tyrian purple pigment come from? 1, a shellfish from the Mediterranean. 2, meteorites. And 3, turtle fingernails.
Ha ha ha. A shellfish from the Mediterranean, and they crushed the shell to get the pigment.
Yes, right? And you needed so many shells to make 1 ounce of the pigment that they have found piles of discarded shells along the Mediterranean coastline.
Fun fact. Yes.
Question 5. The word blue comes from which language? Latin, German, or Arabic?
So it comes from German, but we wrote Arabic because there's also another word for blue that comes from Arabic, which is
Azur? Azur? We're not really sure how to say it.
Yeah, but I know how to say it in French. Azur.
Yes. Okay, and question 6. Why was blue unfashionable for the Romans? 1, it was barbaric. 2, it was difficult to make a beautiful blue. And 3, dead people were blue.
Well, the first two questions are right. It's because it was barbaric, but it also was because it was really difficult to make a beautiful, bright blue.
Good job!
Have fun! Nice chatting with you, and see you at the next video of the next battle. Bye bye!